Okay, a little update on the certified hatchet, but probably applies to Coleman, Coghlan's, Ozark Trail, all the different ones that are like this, like Chinese ones anyway. I think some are made in like India now, I think. Like there's the Stanley brand ones or something, but anyway, just tubular handle, your rubber handle over top of it. Use your pound and a quarter, or I guess it's 20-ounce head. But anyway, so I use this for a while. It works okay. It has like a weird balance to it. It's probably just because of the steel handle. But and I had that weird. This side was kind of cupped in on this side, and this side was sort of the opposite. So you had to grind. You can see that or not, but ground this down as much as I could, and then sharpen it on this side. That's, it's not terrible, but it's got a pretty decent profile to it now. It cuts and it splits and does that kind of stuff. It's I don't know. It's really hard to, it's weird to swing the thing, but I took it in the woods a few times this hunting season, and I had to go through the woods, and there was little branches in the way. I hacked my way through. Like it'll work for you, and I guess you could drill a hole through here and put a roll pin through there if you're worried about the heads coming off, because I guess they sometimes they can do that. But anyway. I wonder about the hardness on these things, and they're not really known for being awesome steel. I think they're kind of like medium carbon or somewhere around there. I have no idea what made out of, but I was looking at this one, and I thought it looked like it was the temper line. I don't know if you can see that or not. It kind of goes right along there. And this side, it's obliterated because I was sanding on it and stuff. But that's actually pretty good. The temper line's got that much. Take quite a while to get wear back to there. And so I figured just beat on it a little bit and see if I can. If you can tell that it's. You can see these dents in it. But I'm gonna pick a spot here where it's not. You just hit it with a claw hammer. See it? Dents that. Then if you go down here below this, it doesn't dent that. But you can just go like you can hit above that line. Can see that or not. There's a bunch of dents here, and then when you cross that line, it stops. So it's not super hard steel. Like it files fairly easily, but it doesn't roll when you chop like hardwood and stuff. It's sort of like when you get a really, really thin edge on it, it seems like when you're chopping hardwood, it doesn't like the edge doesn't roll over, but it sort of like compacts it, however you describe it, but it's sort of. You feel kind of a bit of a burr, but it's like the edge kind of got crushed in or something. But it's. So I think that's about as much angle as you want to. Like it's still thin enough, it'll cut, but it's still splits fairly well. But it's far better than it was originally. It was quite blunt, or some of them are. They kind of vary. But that's a pretty good sign, though. It has a pretty good. Hardness line there, it seems like. So, but it's not over hardened, obviously, because you can cut it really easy with a file, so it's not going to chip. The worst thing can do is you can kind of dent the blade or something, you cut something really hard, but you can file that out fairly easily. But it seems like it has a bit of, yeah, quite a bit of life. You can move it, before you start getting into soft steel. Then it would get super thick anyway, but so anyway, so I think, yeah, it's like $9 or something. It's probably worth it, I guess. So anyway, Thanks for watching.